thoughts on Deal or No Deal.
$22. £250,000. Just one question. It's Love Week on Deal or No Deal. Is normally packed to the rafters with dreams, but we're now full of love, because in Love Week this guy has really learnt all about the power of love. It has cost him so far this week over £100,000. It's not going his way. He's hated it, and it's all because of the love throne. I'm having so much fun this week, it is absolutely brilliant. Yes, the player who I'm about to select will have the opportunity of choosing their own god or goddess of love to sit in the throne of love over there. Let's choose our player today. And now, it's your chance to have fun with the throne. David! Do please take a seat. Welcome to your game, David Nutley from Brighton. A model, a boxer, and an antique dealer. That's quite an interesting combination there, David.
Yeah, it is, yeah.
So which one do you primarily regard yourself as?
Job, obviously, model. But I've not been doing that long. Only really about 6 months, really. And antiques I did in between, really, just to keep the money coming in. I've done that since I was a young age anyway. Learned all off my mum. He's just sitting up there.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Are you nervous?
A little bit, yes.
You look terrified.
I'm not a very good actress then, am I?
No. And who's that?
That's mum's boyfriend.
Hello.
Dave.
Hi. Hi.
And then, yeah,
is that a wig he's wearing?
I wouldn't know. Yeah, and then the boxing, I've been a boxer about 5 years, boxed for Hove. That's really me, personally, I am, like, inside, you know.
What, aggressive?
No, not at all. Yeah, at times, but controlled.
Just have a look, you've got a picture of you. You're doing this.
That was actually in the fight before. And the reason I bought that photo was because that there is my mate Nathan, who actually had to fight for my boxes for the same club as me.
That's awkward.
Yeah, it was awkward. Yeah, really awkward. It's the first time it's ever happened in Hove's history that two fighters have been entered at the same weight.
So yeah. if it's your mate, it's a bit tricky.
It was hard. Yeah, it was hard. But at the end of the day, you know, it depends how much you want it, doesn't it?
Yeah, quite. You got a picture of the modelling?
No, I haven't. I did actually have a couple of photos of my mates as well, but...
Well, I've got... There we go. You see, we knew you weren't going to bring this along, so we got it.
See, I'm quite a modest chap. I'm a humble guy, so I would not have done this, but yeah. Cheers, mate.
So, there's loads more stuff to talk about here, but shall we wait until we get the game underway?
Yeah, why not?
So, let's just do the housekeeping. I need you please to confirm that you chose box number 6 at random before the game began.
Yep.
It is sealed by the independent adjudicator who seals all 22 boxes and is the only person who knows where the money is. Now, normally at this point I go, good luck, but we don't say that for a moment because you now have the chance to select the incumbent of the Throne of Love. We're looking for your own love god or goddess who will come out, they'll bring their box, they'll put it over there on the podium, and then, as we've seen this week, that can turn out to be the most wonderful strategic bonus in your game. Who would you like to choose and why?
It would have to be Meliana. Reason being,
I think we know why. I think it'll emerge during your game. Emiliana, you have been selected to take your place on the Throne of Love. Yes, forecasting the contents of that box, Emiliana should have a fabulous holiday. Okay, now this is the point where I do say, Davey, good luck!
Yeah! I can say, first things first, I've got a system for the first five boxes. So we might have to have a little chat between each other just to remember yesterday's game. Who had the power 5 in their boxes yesterday? Right, Yasser. Right, so we've got number 1.
Right, Amy. Yeah, Yasser. Ruth. Zoe. And Hazel. They had the power 5
just
yesterday.
Just remember, they're the first 5 boxes we're going to take out.
All right.
Amy was number... She's number 1. She had power 5 yesterday, so...
All right, he's working on the principle that the holders of the power 5 yesterday will not have those same big numbers today. Amy, you have box 1. You're on pole position. Get the game underway.
Good luck, Davey.
Come on. Artifacts cost.
Sorry about that, Noel.
No, it's all right. You carry on. You carry on. I'll deal with it.
Right. Yasser.
Yeah.
You said you had a power 5 yesterday.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good man. Thank you, Yasser.
Good luck, mate.
Interesting principle, this. Oh, that's one of them. Oh, it held good for the first one.
Right. I've forgotten already. Who's next? Right, Connor and Ruth.
All right, Ruth, we're still keeping our fingers crossed. The principle is going to hold good. Thank you. 20 grand. Well, it's not power 5.
Zoe.
Thank you, Zoe.
Good luck.
Oh, my word. 15,000, that's a hole over there. In terms of the power 5, you've only hit one of them, but you've hit some big numbers. Wonder if Hazel can get you over there with the 1p.
Come on, Hazel. Do us justice.
Well, I don't don't think anyone's ever done that before. It was a very interesting concept, and it only revealed one of them. Hello, banker! Do I know the price of genuine Greek polystyrene? Yeah, he's like a bull in a china shop. Where's the boxer? Oh, is it? Oh, the banker says it's like looking in a mirror for him. What, the chiseled jaw? Davey! Davey. Oh, he's been very impressed by you, Davey. He looked weak. Oh, well, that's a big compliment. He says, you know, some players don't know what to do with that opportunity that the love seat gives you, and could you get this phone call immediately that you open that box? And he says some people either haven't understood it at all, or they're unsure of the tactics, but he's been listening to the advice you've been giving, and he thinks you've been absolutely spot on, right on the money.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, he thinks you've understood it better than anyone here. Ah, it's a very interesting thing. He's offering you for the box £10,000 minus £250 for the repairs over there. Which on my advance is £9,750. Wow. It's a great opening offer.
That's in £9,000 of my life.
Well, you had to borrow money to get here, didn't you?
Well, he's the new crazy. I mean, he's got sort of 10, 15 tops you're going to be happy seen on TV with. I had to borrow a few hundred quid off a mate, so...
500 quid?
Yeah. But, yeah. Yeah, I'm not going to go, yeah.
No, you're not going to the first
one. Especially an offer like that.
What, the question?
Definitely.
£9,750, deal or no deal?
Thank you very much, no deal. Clarkie, over there, number 17.
Good luck, mate.
Cheers, mate.
Yes! Cheers, mate. Thanks a lot.
Right. Hi, Clive. Well, mate, mate, Clive. We miss you, mate.
Top man.
Okay, Cliff, thank you.
We've had some great laughs and a great time. All the best.
Cheers, mate.
What is it about you guys? You're really, really close and you come up with these wonderful tributes and then you always pull out a big number after you've given the compliment. It's very strange. We are going to rub you down and whatever and ask people to come back to round two. Would you like to do that?
Yep. I haven't got a clue what I'm going to say.
I've not got a clue.
Well, just say come back after the...
Come back for round two. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. She's boxing, and so far I would say that the banker has landed a couple of quite good ones on you there. 15,000, 20,000, 35,000, 50,000, they've all gone. I was patching him up in that break. I got out my cotton bud and I was just doing his eyebrows there. Right. And when you're in one of those clinches, do you talk to each other? Do you?
What's that?
You know, when you're all in that, you know, like we're really in like...
I did have one person whisper something into my ear, and I just laughed at them.
Yeah?
Yeah, I just laughed.
I mean, would it throw you if I said, do you want to come back to my place? Yeah. I'm just staying on this side of the table. No, I might have been pushing it a bit there. Okay. Oh, no! I'm going, wings work, wings work. Where have we got to? Oh, I think we've got another box, haven't we?
Yeah, we have. Number four.
Caroline. Come on.
It's all about boxing and boxes.
Good luck, Gervais.
Thanks very much.
All good?
Yes.
Good. Hello, banker. Oh, did you like that little boxing demonstration we did? This is working for you. You want to say thank you to me? He said he could sit watching our double act all day. And he's willing to put 11.5 grand on it now.
Really good to me, isn't
he? He is.
Yeah, very unusual.
And he's still, of course, got the power of the throne of love.
Yeah, definitely not time for that just yet. Right, yeah, I'm ready for question.
11,500 pounds. Deal or no deal?
No deal.
Straight down.
Came out with you.
The mate that lent you the money for your clothes, what was his name?
John.
John, so he's watching at the moment.
Yeah.
Very jumpy. Yeah. All right, John. Hopefully he's going to get a lot more and pay you back with a little bit of interest.
Yeah.
Thank you, Chris.
Good luck, mate. Cheers, mate.
Properly, I'm going to enjoy this moment. Oh, that's the loveliest thing I've seen. Oh, that was a really touching, tender moment, wasn't it? Oh, excellent. Let's focus on the game.
Debs.
All right, Debs, we think it's you. You've got 50p or a pound in there.
Good luck, baby.
Thanks
so
much.
It blue.
Number 19, are you?
19?
Yeah, 19.
Okay, Eddie.
Good luck, mate. It's been great meeting you.
Yeah? Well, I guess you're right. Your hole's getting bigger.
It's all right.
Well, it's not ideal.
Don't think it can go down. It's the 1p's gone.
1p's gone, yes, absolutely. Absolutely, the 1p's gone.
Can't go down.
We're not going to forget that moment. Chris will never forget it. The 1p. Thank you very much. You were 100% right. He can't go down. In fact, he's going up to 14,000. £13.5 for you, £5 for your mate John.
So, I've got a good chance of having an all three box of them that I want to go. Then I'll probably start using that box.
Okay, you want to go deeper into the game?
Yeah. I like to take risks, but I'm a risk taker. I do like to live life on the edge a little bit. So,
I'll get it. Hello. Thank you.
Do you want to elaborate?
16,000.
No, no. So I've still got 3,000, 1,000, all the blues to go, so... And then I start using tactics. Yeah, I'm ready for the question. Probably I'm going to say this, but yeah, I'm ready for the question.
Okay. £16,000. Deal or no deal?
No deal. Yeah!
Needless to say, if you can get to 8 box with those 3 undiscovered, this is going to be a sensational game. Wouldn't it be brilliant if you have an all blue round?
Come on, my little newborn. Newborn baby. Come on. Looks like a newborn, doesn't he?
Oh. Hey, you're in the soft level. This is going to be blue.
You're not seeing the confetti. Now, no more damage. 50p and a pound have to be on your radar.
Eric. Don't know why.
Thank you, Eric.
You've been good company, Dave. Cheers, I hope to get all what you're looking for.
Hold it right there. Do you particularly want to encourage the nation to come back to your game as well as you did previously?
No.
Come over here, because this is an interesting situation. We are absolutely determined to get the 50p out of the game. If we get to 8 box with those 2 still in play, the boxer, antique dealer, male model undertaker or whatever he is, is in a jolly good position. But the next box is absolutely critical. That's why you'll come back. Amazing chap, actually, you are. Find that 50p or a pound, Davey, and we'll be feeling a lot better.
Number 11.
Okay, it's the newbie. Christy, welcome to the game.
Dude, really, 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 really needed to be a 50p. No pressure on anything.
Oh, thanks.
Okay, Christy, you are welcome. Please open box 11. I think he's going to describe this as very precarious. Hello?
Yeah, wrong risk taker.
Ah, newborn baby Kevin. And what a wonderful delivery. Yes. Used to be a boxer. At university. Oh. Go on, what did you specialise in? He specialised in his boxing career in low blows. £4,000. That is a crash from 16 to 4.
So I'm ready for the question, Scott.
£4,000, deal or no deal?
No deal.
Right, don't forget, you've got the goddess of love here, and if you take box 3, you'll get an offer immediately after it. Use it wisely.
I've got a funny feeling. Don't know if I want to go there at all, because I think I've just got a funny feeling to be number.
Right.
How many boxes have I got left to go?
Well,
2.
We haven't started the round yet.
Have we not?
No. No, we haven't. No, the banker is standing in the middle of the ring at the moment, waiting for you to 15. Get off your stool.
15.
Okay, we're going with you, Gaz.
Good luck, man.
Let's have an all blue round.
Seven.
nonsense about him now, I seriously would not want to meet you in the room. Come on, Michael, we want an all blue round. Right. I find this fascinating. I think his style is fascinating. Steve, roof will go off if this is blue, an all blue round. Would be just sensational at this point. If it's 50p, we're laughing.
I really hope it's a 50p, Davey. Good luck, mate.
Touch of the autumn.
Oh, sorry about that.
Well, that's a five box, isn't it? Hello. I think you are in trouble because he could just decide to only open one box.
It is at 750 in that box. Yeah. To be honest, sir, I could really do £1,000 right now, so. £1,000 would be a massive amount of money to me, to be honest with you, £1,000, so I'll be happy with £1,000, so I'll probably go all the way. I've been telling you. I'm being serious.
Well, he's gone pretty quiet.
I'm glad to hear it.
Thank you. You've created a game and a half here, haven't you? How do you feel about being back at 16,000?
That's pretty good.
It's not the offer. The offer's 21,000. You say you're brave. Nobody wins life-changing money without making at least one brave decision.
Do you think the banker would tell me what he would offer if I decided to say no deal and there was 100,000 in that box?
Okay, so that's a very pessimistic inquiry. And here comes his response. Your question was, if you were to say no deal,
yeah,
and then open that box,
yeah,
and see 100,000,
yeah,
you wanted to know what he would then be offering you.
Yeah, even though there's 75 still there.
He'd be offering you £4,000.
Chris.
It's a lot of money, mate. And the way you're speaking, you're convinced that Emiliano's got a big one in the box. And if you do, no deal, you're going to have to open three on here right now, because you're convinced it's there. So, you know, seriously think about
it. Yes. But he's saying he doesn't want to complicate it, baby. But... I love it. Okay, thank you. I love it. In view of the fact that you believe that box number 3 has got a very large sum of money in it, he is prepared to allow you, therefore Emiliana, to swap that box for another box. So, if you are absolutely certain that it's 75,000 or 100,000 over there in box 3, you could actually bring it to the table.
Davey, you've asked what the fallout would be if you took one of the big ones out.
No.
Maybe the banker's honest and will give you the offer if you took one of the 3 small ones out, and then you can weigh up the risk between the 2.
Thank you, baby. Baby speaks. you do decide to say no deal, and you find the 750 in that box, the offer will be 34,000. And the last thing he said was, I hope that's helpful.
Davey, you say that your blazers are red and that, so you can swap with any of these boxes. And then you've got a brilliant chance, haven't you?
He's just giving my thing, he's giving my answer.
You think you're there?
Yeah. Right. Yeah, I'm ready for question.
Yes?
Yep, yep.
£21,000. Deal or no deal? We've got a little bit of business. The thing that's burning away in my head is, would you have swapped that box? Because we have to play on with honesty.
Yeah, I would have done, yeah. If I'd said no deal,
yeah,
I would have swapped that box for number 13.
Right.
I don't know why.
Let's do it.
Kim, but she just...
Right.
Since playing your games, blue seems to be next to blues.
Kim? Kim? So what would have happened now?
I would have picked 13.
Okay, so now, Emiliana, if you'd be good enough, we're really hoping that this is going to be 100,000. Thank you. We would have had an offer at this point. Hello. Yeah, go on. I know, you and me both, he's saying. This game never ever ceases to amaze us. Well, he's gutted that he would not have the opportunity to offer you £4,000. That was a knockout blow, he says. Okay, well, we've got to play on, and we got two in this round.
I would have left 22 to the end.
Right, okay, so it's 9 or 3, 3 or 9. Where are you going?
9.
9?
Yeah.
Okay, Linda, open box 9, give us 75,000. Thank you. No. So, Kim, number 3. Okay, Linda wouldn't do it, so Kim, would you please do it? Oh my word. Hello. Oh, the offer at this point would have been £1,200. Oh, this is the moment where we find out what you actually brought to the table.
Oh, I can't believe it.
And it's quite a victory. £21,000 in your pocket already, because you brought... It's all right, then. Brian, thank you. Open box 22. £3,000 sitting over there. Wow. Davey, seriously, what's £21,000 going to do for you?
Oh, I'm going to help out Mum. Help out Mum.
Don't forget John.
Yeah.
500 quid, got to go back to John for the clothes.
Yeah, he's a good bloke, John. Cheers, mate.
It was a good idea to lend the clothes and then we dressed you like that. Davey, I'm so pleased. It's been a real pleasure to meet you. Good
and
luck
you.
In whatever career. What a fantastic contest. I just think that was...
Morgan's Perfect Recall.